gentlemen, Times Now was the first channel to expose the conversion factory in Kerala. Something that was confirmed by the NIA in its report to the Supreme Court of India. The court that led to the top courts ordering a probe into the alleged love jihad cases in the state. What we question was the state inaction against those who were accused of being involved in such activities of conversion. Now, Times Now has a video proof that adds credence to it. The video shows Love Jihad accused Shafin Jahan leading a mob and damaging hospital property. But despite visual evidence being captured on CCTV, the cops refused to name him in the FIR. Why was he given a free run? We will debate that just after this short report.
Shafin Jahan is a 27-year-old man from Kerala, and he is under the NIA scanner in a Love Jihad case. He's accused of converting Akhila into Hadia. But even if the probe agency's investigators' role in Love Jihad case, Times Now has accessed a video that captures him leading a mob of angry protesters inside a hospital in Kollam. In the video, Shafin is seen inciting his supporters to shout slogans and damage hostel property. His men are seen pushing around the hospital staff.
That is Shafin Jahan, because I was not aware, but now there are a lot of media posts and all against him. I have checked his Facebook post also. So the same person, that Shafin Jahan by Facebook post name, that person is the person who has created problem here.
But despite the thuggery on tape, the cops turning a blind eye, refusing to name him in the FIR, only mentioning unknown people in the accused list. The cops ignoring the visual proof completely.
Regarding this CCTV incident, I do not have personal knowledge about it, but I know that there are crime cases against him in the Kerala police. Mm-hmm. Maybe this could be one among that.
Mm-hmm. But you are aware that SDPI was involved in that incident where a hospital,
Yeah.
Well, was the case registered? Is it against SDPI activists?
Yeah, I think so. Recently, I got a petition from one person. So only through him, I got some insight into that case.
The incident comes on the back of state.
Debate on the News Hour at 9. Why indulge a love jihadi? The debate on the News Hour at 10. Probe reaching right verdict.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
The reality of Shafin Jahan is there on tape. And as I introduce my guest, I'll show you some key documents that will talk about Shafin Jahan, the man who was married to Akhila Asokan, actually whose name after conversion became Hadia. And what does Shafin Jahan do and how does the state treat him? All of that coming up. Let me introduce my panel tonight on the big story that we are talking about. The story of the Love Jihad Nexus tape. That's the hashtag, ladies and gentlemen. Do send us your tweets and do send us your questions on involved.in/newshour. And joining me this evening, Dr. Sombit Patra, national spokesperson of the BJP, joining me in our studios in Noida. M.R. Venkatesh, political analyst, Sandeep Singh, author, and somebody who leans towards the RSS, Dr. Dinesh Vashne, leader of the CPI, Dr. T.A. Rehmani, president of the Muslim Political Council of India, and Alimuddin Khan, political analyst, joining us live from Srinagar. But before I go across to my first question, let me show you. You've seen those visuals on your screen. We've identified the man, and everybody has identified with his Facebook post that is Shafin Jahan. That incident on the CCTV coming up on the 24th of January 2017. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the FIR copy, the first information report filed on the 24th of January 2007 at 9 p.m. at night. And this talks about nobody. In fact, the accused is an unknown. Accused, completely unknown. Why is Shafin Jahan being protected by the state? In fact, look at these NIA documents, the National Investigation Agency, which talks about Akhila Asokan, which is Hadia, who married Shafin Jahan, an SDPI PFI activist with criminal antecedents. The NIA report talks about a criminal antecedents, and this is not just any NIA report. This is the report that was submitted to the Supreme Court of India. And this talks about the criminal antecedents of Shafin Jahan, but Shafin Jahan gets a huge counsel to protect him. Kapil Sibal, senior counsel, protects him, and the state of Kerala does not even file an FIR when it's on tape that he was breaking up the equipment in a hospital in Kerala. Dr. Sambit Patra, what would you call this?
No, I would call this as a nefarious design that is well present, entrenched deeply in the Kerala administration, not only in the Kerala killings. In the killing field of Kerala, we have seen as to how, despite the fact that the people who have been killing the RSS and the BJP workers, they're not punished. Over here in the Love Jihad case also, we are seeing the complicity of the administration. And let me remind you, Navika, of the very fact that when this whole thing came up for hearing in the Supreme Court, what did the Supreme Court say? The Supreme Court had three very important phrases. Let me quote those phrases. Phrase number one is, we want a proper investigation which is unbiased and neutral, and that is why we are...
Dr. Sambit Patra, the CEO of the hospital where all this violence is taking place, has also told our cameras, and he has come out and said that the person on the Facebook that we have identified is the same person who actually came and created the violence in the hospital. The police doesn't name him, the state doesn't name him, the NIA names him. Isn't this the nexus?
That's what I was saying. I mean, what did the Supreme Court say? The Supreme Court say, if you want to know the truth about the Love Jihad, we have to hand over the case, the investigation, to NIA. Why? Because we want an unbiased and a neutral investigation, a neutral report. Now, that is a castigation. That is a finger pointed towards the Kerala police. That the Kerala police is not doing its job in an unbiased and a neutral way. Somewhere there is administrative interference, political interference over the Kerala police. And that's what you are saying right now. That despite the fact that we had Shafin Jahan in a video that was rightly projected in front of us over here breaking the glasses, the panes of a hospital window, but we have the FIR the next day, but the FIR is against unknown people. We don't find the mention of Shafin Jahan, despite we can clearly see him.
Well, Mr. Dinesh Vashne, it's very clear that the Kerala state is trying to protect Shafin Jahan. What is the objective? What is the motive of the Kerala state protecting Shafin Jahan if it's not the allegation that's now getting more proof that there is a conversion factory that's running, and Shafin Jahan is an important element of that conversion factory where girls are converted through marriage into the Muslim religion? And this conversion, as the Supreme Court is hearing the matter, is a coercive conversion that is taking place and has great national security ramifications as well. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, isn't it proved now with the fact that the video is there of Shafin Jahan creating violence, but nobody in the police actually filing an FIR against him?
Look, Navika, let me first inform you that yesterday three RSS men have hurled the bomb at the CPM office and two of our workers are seriously injured. And if Sambit Patra says that it is a killing factory, he should know who is the killing organization.
No, where are those? How do you know RSS men have burned? How do you know? How can you make this claim? This RSS men have hurled bombs. RSS men never hurled bombs anywhere. Rather, the RSS men have been killed time and again.
Earlier also, they were found making bombs. Earlier, they were found making bombs in Kerala.
Please, don't come up with this bunkum talks. These are absolute bunkum talks.
propagated by the left ideology in Kerala. If you found anyone making bomb, why no arrests have been made? Why these people have not been convicted by any court in Kerala? So please don't float. Please don't.
Why are you diverting the issue, Mr. Dinesh Vashne?
Dying declaration. Dying declaration.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne.
Not Pehlu Khan.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne.
Convict over here. Safin Jahan. Not Pehlu Khan.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne, I accuse you. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, I accuse you of trying to derail this debate. Why don't you answer the questions that are confronting you? Why don't you answer the question of Safin Jahan?
I am telling you about Safin Jahan.
After roaming about everywhere, he's coming back to the question now.
Care of it. The NIA has done. The Supreme Court has not said that they will be
on the... Is this what they're taking care of? An FIR against unknown persons? Is this what they're taking care of?
Inquiry will be done.
Is this what they're taking care of?
Let this... They are taking care of. They are taking care of. They are taking rest.
They filed an FIR against unknown people. Unknown people, when Safin Jahan is caught on camera, the camera is playing on your screen.
Let them investigate first. Let the investigation go on. Let the investigation be completed first. Everything can be revealed on the public media.
Once again, trying to derail the entire story, Mr. Dinesh Vashne.
One single example of
Mr. Dinesh Vashne. No, let's not go to the killing fields. Let's come back to love jihad.
I will not allow you to derail this discussion. Mr. Dinesh Vashne. Bangladesh, please. RSS is hiding.
Where do you bring in Hindus and Rohingyas?
Because of the failure of the demonetization.
And Pehlu Khan into this debate.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you are running around in circles and you are deliberately
petrol also into the debate.
Crude oil, they are looting the nation.
You are deliberately running around in circles.
Can this be
Dr. T. A. Rehmani, Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you are speaking bunkum. I'm sorry to say this, but Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you are a respected professor, but today you are talking bunkum. I hope this is not how you conduct your classes. Dr. T. A. Rehmani. Dr. T. A. Rehmani, let me ask you a pointed question. Dr. Rehmani, the visuals are very clear. The CEO of the hospital is very clear. He talks about Safin Jahan coming and indulging in violence and breaking window panes and trying to damage the property of the hospital. We've seen the FIR. The FIR is against unknown people. Unknown people. And Mr. Dinesh Vashne says the Kerala government is investigating the matter. Sir, this video pertains to 24th of January 2017. We are in 15th of September 2017. There have been 9 months to investigate this entire issue. What is the Kerala government doing if they cannot match the face that a news channel like Times Now can match from the Facebook post of Safin Jahan to the Kerala visuals and go and discuss this with the CEO of the hospital? If we can link these facts together, what investigation is the Kerala police and the Kerala government doing, Mr. T. A. Rehmani?
Navika, at the outset, you said it very clearly that Safin Jahan is a political activist and he belongs to PFI, that Popular Front of India, and SDPI, which is
I didn't say it. The NIA charge sheet says it.
It's fine, but it proves that he is a political activist, and in political activity there are so many demonstrations and violent demonstrations all over the country by all the political
inside
parties
hospitals?
In the country. There is no
inside hospitals?
One exclusion, and in most of the
so inside hospitals you should be allowed to carry on with your violence. Is that what you're justifying?
Inside the assembly house, inside the hospital. Why not? So I'm not justifying. Don't put your tongue into my mouth. I'm not justifying. I'm just quoting as you have quoted the NIA. Now I'm quoting whatever is happening. And in most of the cases, what the police FIR is, it is for the unknown names. And I want to remind you, in the Junaid mob lynching case, there was a clear CCTV footage is available to the police, and it was registered FIR with unknown people. So this is the routine work of our police. So why you are specifying this particular
routine work of police? Dr. Sambit Patra wants to come in before I go to MR Venkatesh.
And I'm not approving. I'm not endorsing it. But this is the routine and everybody knows it.
If you're not endorsing, allow me to speak. Okay, sir. Now, number one, we have to come to the crux of the matter. I think we all have to speak sense. Let me inject some sense into this whole debate with the fact that Mr. Jahan, Safin Jahan, his marriage was annulled by the Kerala High Court. And remember when Safin Jahan applied in the Supreme Court, Kapil Sibal supporting him as his lawyer, the question is the Supreme Court handed this to NIA. What did Safin Jahan said? He objected to this. And do you know what the Supreme Court said thereafter? The Supreme Court said, and I quote, the petitioner, Mr. Jahan, does not desire the correct and independent view of the controversy. I mean, the Supreme Court has passed an adverse comment on Safin Jahan that somewhere Safin Jahan wants the truth to be hidden. And in fact, the state administration is complicit in trying to hide the truth to come to the forefront.
The Supreme Court has not come out with any verdict. So you don't try to pose as if the Supreme Court has given some verdict. Don't try to pose as if the Supreme Court has given a final verdict. There are some observations.
Supreme Court has directed NIA to investigate.
Supreme Court has directed NIA to investigate further.
You can go through the observation of Supreme Court where the Supreme Court had ordered the NIA to take over the investigation.
No, I have seen.
You may disagree with it. But this fact is,
don't try to pose that only you can talk sense.
And these are
every nonsense you people are talking. You keep on saying that only you are talking sense, and all other are nonsense people.
Saying that Safin Jahan somewhere does not want the truth to come to the forefront. Are you also a lawyer of Safin Jahan? Are you also the lawyer of Safin Jahan along with Kapil Sibal?
He has lawfully married a girl.
Lawfully married a girl, sir. Why did the Kerala High Court annul the marriage? So why did the Kerala High Court annul the marriage, sir? Sir, do you believe you are higher than the Kerala High Court? So why do you consider yourself higher than the Kerala High Court, Mr. Rehmani? Mr. Rehmani, are you higher than the Kerala High Court? The Kerala High Court annulled the marriage.
The same Kerala Court.
No. Are you higher than the Kerala High Court?
Because after High Court, the Supreme Court is there.
And the Supreme Court has handed the whole issue to NIA. So you would not consider the Kerala High Court. You would bypass the Kerala High Court and you would say very conveniently over here that the Kerala High Court was wrong.
Dr. Rehmani, the matter is being looked into. Matter is pending before the Supreme Court. You are right. But the fact is the Supreme Court has desired an independent investigation into this entire case, which should be monitored by a former judge of the Supreme Court. And it has said that the NIA should come in. MR Venkatesh, when we come to the specific issue of Mr. Jahan actually going and breaking up all that equipment in the hospital authorities, the CEO has admitted to Times Now, and he has gone on record to say that the man on the Facebook post, Safin Jahan, is the same as the man who had created the violence and damaged the property of the hospital. Can't Kerala police or can't the Kerala government piece together this investigation in the last 8 months? Is this now completely clear that there is a nexus? And that's why we are calling it the Love Jihad Nexus tape, because this tape completely exposes the nexus that exists between the Kerala government and the Love Jihad propagators.
Okay. Navika, first thing first, I agree with Mr. Rehmani. At times for the police do record an FIR stating that it is on unknown people, and that is a fact of the matter. But after 9 months, if it is still unknown, when videographic evidences are there, and when your channel has gone to the spot and got some independent witness to testify, I think what is the police doing? Police is just perhaps flying kites. Obviously, there is something more than meets the eye. And this cannot be done unless there is a command performance. And I have always held that in Kerala, I can share you with great amount of authority, because I come from that part of the country, that there is a huge nexus between the communists and the jihadi terror group and certain people who fund these two people simultaneously. That is why NIA probe is not only on this specific case in terms of Lao Jihad. It is also about how do these people get money through certain channels, through Hawala channels from the Gulf, and how is it channeled to these political parties, and how these political parties convert into all these type of operations, anti-national operations and anti-social operations. So there is a larger context and a very limited text. The limited text, of course, is that the marriage was annulled by the Kerala High Court. And wait a minute, don't talk. I never interfered. Please listen, Mr. Varshne. If it is you, please wait. If it is somebody else, please wait.
Please.
Now, as far as this whole thing is concerned, in Kerala...
you will not be allowed. You will not be allowed. You can't generalize the thing.
Not allowing anyone.
No, why should it not be allowed? What did you do in Gauri Lankesh case, sir?
Gauri Lankesh case, what evidence is there? Communists never supported any communal organization.
Now you are jolly well at liberty to go to the Supreme Court if you believe in the Supreme Court and do it. So don't shout over me, Mr. Varshne. You are becoming a very wrong example for your students. Whosoever are there, God bless them. Please wait and listen to me. Gauri Lankesh, what evidence is there that you have said? मेरे पास एविडेंस है सर हाउ पीपल कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी इज लिंक्ड टू जिहादी टेररिस्ट एंड इफ यू हैव द करेज टेक मी टू द कोर्ट
Every
sir, sir your harmony and disharmony don't teach me
on every
tell me what evidence you had on the Gauri Lankesh case
come on Mr. Ali Khan, let me get you in.
Because sir, if left to Mr. Dinesh Varshne, he will dominate this entire debate. He will talk about every other issue, but he will not talk about Shafin Jahan. Alimuddin Khan, sir, I am asking you a direct question. That's the question. Love Jihad is the beginning. What about the links with organizations, terror organizations abroad? What about connections with jihadi organizations? What about connections with the ISIS? What about taking girls from Kerala to the ISIS and taking
terror
them
funding.
There? In fact, the last
terror
reports
funding.
Of the NIA say that at least 21 such girls from Kerala have been landing in the ISIS in Syria. Isn't this something that concerns everybody, Mr. Alimuddin Khan? Or will the Congress just look the other way, because anything that's anti-BJP is something that the Congress will blindly follow? Are you not worried about the terror nexus? Are you not worried about the Love Jihad nexus, which is now caught on tape, Mr. Alimuddin Khan? This video shows Shafin Jahan, the so-called husband of Akhila Asokan Urf Hadia, who, according to the NIA report, is an SDPI or a PFI activist with criminal antecedents. But what does this FIR say? Unknown people. He's seen on camera breaking equipment. He's seen and identified by the CEO of the hospital. But the police can't see that connection at all.
Navika ji, first of all, let me tell you, it was UPA government when this NIA was constituted and this case was given to NIA in Kerala, and this Love Jihad or terrorist activities were unearthed from Kerala to going to even going to Srinagar, even going to Srinagar. As far as the real issue
the case was handed over to NIA, are you aware of that? Pandit Nehru ne NIA ko nahi diya re baba. सब कुछ पंडित नेहरू ने नहीं किया.
लेट मी स्पीक संबिजी.
व्हाट लेट यू स्पीक? यू आर सेइंग दैट द यूपीए गवर्नमेंट स्टार्टेड द एनआईए इन्वेस्टिगेशन.
लेट मी स्पीक.
इन द सफीन जहान केस द एनआईए इन्वेस्टिगेशन बिगिंस विद द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ओनली लास्ट मंथ.
सर यू आर
नॉट जवाहरलाल नेहरू.
डोंट लूज योर पेशेंस सर.
आई नो आई एम डॉक्टर. आई एम ट्रीटिंग द पेशेंट्स.
Please have patience, sir.
No, I know. I need to treat the patients, sir, who have forgotten their history.
See,
you have run back to the UPA days. While the NIA investigation was instituted only recently.
Get your facts right, sir.
No, please speak, sir. Sorry if I interrupted. Please speak.
I, I am saying, sir, this whole thing is done by the RSS. RSS did discrimination with the Dalits and the lower caste of the Hindus of this country.
Whole thing is done
That's
by RSS.
Why they started converting to Islam or to Christianity. And after giving them this
what is he saying? Because RSS is present, so people started converting Islam. Into
now
Islam
you are doing politics on it. When they are converting
what
to Islam
saying,
or Christianity.
No, what are you saying?
I will not allow this.
Because RSS is present, people have converted themselves to Christianity and Islamism. Are you supporting this conversion? Are you supporting this conversion? Are you supporting ISIS?
I will not allow you to say something against the RSS.
Please embrace the lower caste of this country. Please, अरे देशों में जाके गले मिलते हो अपने हिंदू भाइयों को गले मिला लो ये प्रॉब्लम ही खत्म हो जाएगी.
अरे हिंदू भाइयों को गले मिलाने के राहुल गांधी को कहो जाके आप राहुल गांधी को कहो हिंदू भाइयों को गले लगाने के लिए. वो तो सुबह से शाम रोहिंग्यान को गले लगाए हुए हैं.
कश्मीर में जाता है
रोहिंग्यान मुसलमान को गले लगा के रखते हैं. हिंदू भाइयों को गले कैसे लगाएंगे?
मंथन करिए. आपको मंथन करने की जरूरत है.
मंथन
कांग्रेस पे इल्जाम मत
लगाइए. यूनिवर्सिटी में मंथन करूं?
रोक लगाई थी कांग्रेस ने तो इसको कंट्रोल किया.
आई डोंट नो द डिबेट इज ऑन सम इशू. यू ऑल आर रशिंग टुवर्ड्स सम अदर पॉइंट.
आप रोहिंग्या को गले क्यों नहीं लगा रहे? आपको क्या तकलीफ है रोहिंग्या से?
संदीप सिंह कौन से कम्युनिस्ट? संदीप सिंह
खाली हिंदू को इंसान समझते हैं?
देश में हमारा इट्स एन एब्सर्ड स्टेटमेंट बीइंग मेड बाय अलीमुद्दीन खान हु सेज जस्ट द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द आरएसएस इन केरला इज मेकिंग पीपल एम्ब्रेस क्रिश्चियनिटी एंड
Islam.
The Muslim Islam religion. I mean, is
see,
there any logic in that statement?
See, Navika,
do you find any logic, Mr. Sandeep Singh?
See, Navika, today again the communist and the jihadist Islamist forces have been caught naked. They've been caught pants down. These guys are talking about RSS. You should do a show how they treat Ahmadiyya Muslims. Can you ask these three gentlemen, do you they visit Ahmadiyya Mosque? So let's stop talking about RSS and Hindus, you know. And what Hindu organizations have been saying so far, they have proven correct.
अगर हमें भारत को एक रखना है तो आरएसएस को अपना रास्ता बदलना पड़ेगा.
अरे तुम्हारे बाप का है क्या भारत को एक रखना है? तुम कौन होते हो बोलने वाले भारत को एक रखना है?
Let him Mr. Sandeep Singh, don't display your superiority complex. There is absolutely no space for supercilious statements being made. कि आपको बोलने दे रहे हैं यही बहुत है. आप कौन होते हैं किसी को बोलने देने वाले? संदीप सिंह जी
भारत को एक रखना है
इस देश में सबको बोलने की इजाजत है और संदीप सिंह जी सब बोलेंगे इक्वल हक से बोलेंगे. जितना हक आपको है उतना हर मुसलमान को भी हक है. तो संदीप सिंह जी लेट्स नॉट गेट सुपर सीरियस अबाउट दिस.
ये बात गद्दारी का है. भारत को एक रखने के बाद ये नहीं कर सकते. एट द टॉप ऑफ हैट यू टॉक ऑफ डिवाइडिंग द कंट्री.
See, I firmly believe that the debate has to be brought back to its track.
Let's bring the debate back to the track. We are talking about Shafeen Jahan.
Yes.
We are talking about the visuals. We are talking about the video link. We are talking about the tape that completely exposes the nexus. We are talking about the love jihad nexus tape.
And it just shows very clearly.
And in this tape, Shafeen Jahan is somebody who's seen openly trying to create violence and trying to destroy property of
hospitals.
He's been identified by Times Now through its Facebook post. He's been identified by the CEO of the hospital. What is preventing the Kerala police from identifying him? Why do they call him an unknown in the FIR? Why do they call him an unknown?
You know, it's a case of precedence rule. The police has failed completely what you have proven.
I firmly believe we all are mature people, and on this serious debate, we should be sticking to the facts of the matter. What's the fact of the matter? Well, yes, the administration is complicit. How do we derive that the administration is complicit? Look at the phrases that the Supreme Court has used. There's a pattern to conversion. It's not my phrase. Pattern to conversion, and this pattern to conversion has wider ramification. This is what the court has said. Thereafter, if I would remind you, 2010 V.S. Achyutanandan, the Chief Minister of Kerala, what did he say? He said that I see because of this conversion, there is a demographic change occurring in Kerala. It's not the BJP or RSS Sarasangachalak saying. It is the Kerala's Chief Minister, the left Chief Minister V.S. Achyutanandan, who is saying that. Oman Chandy submits a report regarding all these conversions on 22nd June 2012. And what did he say? 7,713 people converted to Islam between 2006 and 2012. 2,195 Hindu women converted to Islam between 2009 and 2012. 492 Christian women converted to Islam during 2009 and 2012.
Don't tell
and the biggest
data,
issue is we have only recently
data,
seen
Dr.
as to how some of these people who were converted, including Yahya Khan, who was converted from Christianity to Islam, they were all imported. They were all exported to Syria to fight for ISIS. This is a big issue. Why are we fighting like this?
You are not
Alimuddin ji, please try to understand, sir. Let's not fight like this. Let's understand the seriousness of the issue.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne, Mr. Dinesh Vashne, may I remind you, Mr. Dinesh Vashne, that the entire issue of love jihad is not something that has been created now by the BJP. These cases have come up even Dinesh Vashne ji. Dinesh Vashne ji, at least please listen to the question.
What is the progress of that person who was printing the counterfeit note of ₹2,000 in Kerala belonging to the BJP RSS? Why don't you ask the NIA to investigate the vigilante?
Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you are a professor, and I want to ask you just one question. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, can I get your attention, sir?
Did the NIA ever visited
how do students in your class get your attention, sir, if they have a question to ask?
Come on, Navika.
Mr. Dinesh Vashne, how do students in your class get your attention if they have a question to ask?
You stop me, but you don't stop Sambit Patras. You don't stop.
I am not stopping you, sir. I am only trying to ask you a question. Mr. Dinesh Vashne, you are a professor.
Yep,
you
please.
Are somebody who should
but
be used
that,
to
I
questions
to ask
being asked
question.
To you.
No, you please allow me to speak a question to you.
Professor will answer the question first before he asks the question. Professor, first you answer my question and then I will. Professor, please answer my question. Answer my question. My question to you, Mr. Dinesh Vashne, is that these cases of love jihad have been reported since 1996. It is not even in the BJP government under Prime Minister Narendra Modi. These cases date back to 1996. And let me tell you the observation of Mr. K.T. Sankaran, the then Justice of the Kerala High Court in 2009, who said that the responsibility of the state government to stop forced conversions and even ask them to enact a law to protect victims of forced conversions. This was said in 2009. There was no Narendra Modi government then. So why is the love jihad,
Navika,
why is the forced conversion something that's been an issue since then? Why are you making it an issue now?
Okay, all right, Can I make an answer?
Yes, please answer.
Can I give you answer as a professor?
You answer, look, don't make an answer.
First of all, no. Why? When she said I am a professor, she will ask me a question.
How can you make an answer, sir?
A professor can also ask a question to a student. We ask a question to the student while teaching. Come on, Ramit Patra, don't be that subjective.
Oh, sir.
Please,
we are not your
student,
answer,
sir.
First. How sweet look, of you. We are not students, sir. We are political
no,
aspirants over here.
No, I am talking to Navika, not to you. You don't barge in. You have a habit
also,
to barge in.
I don't gather
you
that Navika is also a student. Sir, we are professors.
I have
why bring Mr.
Why,
Modi
why can't
into
Navika be my student? I teach research scholars. Come on, my students of my age is
sometimes.
Come on. You become a student. Sambit Patra, for a little while, you become a
student.
You've tried your doctor's treatment, hasn't worked. Let's try and become students now. Yes, answer the question, sir.
Will you please ask Sambit Patra to keep mum so that I can answer? Look, whether it is a case of 1996 or now, or 2009, At the point of time, let 2009, we were not in the government. Even if the Kerala High Court has annulled the marriage and they say pattern of this thing, the Supreme Court has already said there should be an inquiry by the NIA under the supervision of the retired Supreme Court judge. Let the inquiry be ordered, inquiry happen.
Why don't you respond to this?
At the same time, firstly, let me ask you a question.
Shafin Jahan.
Shafin Jahan is called somebody with criminal antecedents by the NIA, sir. Why is the Kerala government not calling him somebody with criminal antecedents? Why is the FIR saying unknown? Why is the FIR saying? Because you want to continue the Love Jihad factory in Kerala? Is that why?
No, we are not a judge.
The NIA is calling him somebody with criminal antecedents.
Nobody in this country support the forcible conversion. Not a single political party in this country can support the forcible conversion. But at the same time, no political party in the country other than the BJP support the politics of RSS, of division, of hatred against the communal harmony, against the national integration.
So Supreme Court
that
is not causing driven
a problem
by the RSS and
because
BJP
RSS and BJP is raising a bogey of communism to hide the failures of demonetization, violence by the cause of Vigilante, Abhinav Bharat.
Oh God, love jihad and demonetization.
Murder of Gauri Lankesh.
Love jihad and what is the connection with demonetization, sir? What is love jihad's connection with demonetization?
Highest prices of essential commodities in India.
You want GST on love jihad? You want GST on love jihad, sir?
That is why they are raising all this love jihad. Cause Vigilante.
Yes, Dr. Sambit Patra.
प्रोफेसर साहब आपको सुना, अब हमें भी सुन लीजिए, अपने स्टूडेंट्स को भी सुन लीजिए, ठीक है? अब प्रोफेसर साहब क्लास खत्म होगा, घंटी बज गई है, क्लास खत्म, दूसरा क्लास शुरू होगा,
उम्र में भी छोटे हो, पढ़ाई में भी छोटे हो, पहले पूरी सुन लो संबित पात्रा,
ठीक है?
पहले पूरी सुनो,
अब पूरा प्लीज बोलने दीजिए,
तुम बोलोगे नहीं
प्लीज प्रोफेसर साहब, ऐसे मत करिए सर, ये प्लीज क्लासरूम.
ओके, आई हैव टू गेट अदर पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू कम इन. यस यस, डॉक्टर संबित पात्रा,
कीप फ्रॉम स्पीकिंग
नॉट
सर, प्लीज अलाउ अदर्स टू स्पीक, दिस इज नॉट द वे ऑफ कंडक्टिंग सर, प्लीज.
और तुम्हारी पार्लियामेंट्री कमेटी,
ओके ओके, दिनेश वाशने, मिस्टर दिनेश वाशने, अलाउ अलाउ, देयर इज एमआर वेंकटेश हु वांट्स टू मेक अ पॉइंट, डॉक्टर एमानी एंड डॉक्टर संबित पात्रा. सो डॉक्टर संबित पात्रा फर्स्ट.
फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट नाविका, इफ यू वुड रिमेंबर ओनली अ फ्यू डेज अगो योर ओन चैनल हैड कम आउट विद द एक्सपोजर अबाउट अ दावा स्क्वाड, दैट देयर वाज अ दावा स्क्वाड देयर एज टू हाउ दीज वुमन हु वर फोर्सिबली कन्वर्टेड और रादर ब्रेन वॉश्ड एंड कन्वर्टेड बाय इस्लामिक रेडिकलाइजेशन, दे वर into isolated confinement, you know, they were confined in isolation, and there was a place called as Satsarini, Satyasarini, where these people were being brainwashed. So it, in fact, do you think that all these things was happening without the state administration not knowing anything? This is nothing but a very systemic and a structured arrangement. So when we have a systemic and a structured arrangement under the nose of the state government, and the state government closes his eyes very conveniently, does not issue an FIR in the name of the person against whom a huge case is going on. Remember, the case went to the Kerala High Court. From the Kerala High Court, the case comes to the Supreme Court. There is a video in the Facebook. You have linked the person Shafiq Jahan over here. So do you think that the administration, which is a huge organization, was oblivious of all these issues? Absolutely not. There is a design, and
there is a design, and let me get, before I go to MR Venkatesh, let me get in Alimuddin Khan on this. Mr. Alimuddin Khan, the governments in Kerala continue to alternate between the left and the Congress party. Clearly, both the left and the Congress party have turned a blind eye to this entire Love Jihad factory that operates, the conversion factory that operates. Why otherwise would KT, the Honorable Judge of the Supreme of the Kerala High Court, KT Sankaran, actually talk about the state coming in and enacting a law? It's been going on since 2009 when your government was there, Alimuddin Khan. The Congress,
Navika,
the party that you lead towards, even if you don't belong to the Congress.
2016, Congress was in power. Mr. Oman Chaddi was chief minister. There was no such problem. No killing of any workers. No any jihad. No any kind of this nonsense which is going on today. It
you
all
so?
Started before
you
three
think
and
so?
A, period, before three and 3 years.
MR Venkatesh?
When BJP came into power.
MR Venkatesh?
And CPI came to power in Kerala. So who is responsible? CPIM or the RSS? They are creating problem in Kerala. You have to ask them why they
MR
are doing
Venkatesh?
So. If you are not comfortable, impose president, exercise 354, impose president rule there. What for you
now,
are waiting?
Now, Navika.
And as far as this conversion
stops,
is concerned,
I will do it. Otherwise, I will shout over
it. Because of the weakness of the RSS.
Okay,
because
okay,
RSS
okay.
Is failed to give respect to the Dalits of this country.
Take a deep breath, sir.
That is the problem. That is the real problem. You don't want to correct the real problem. You are first. You want to create the problem.
Okay.
Then you want to do the politics.
Sir, only,
that is the problem. Okay. The RSS and the BJP.
Okay. टेक सम वाटर पानी थोड़ा पी लीजिए सर, पानी पी लीजिए, बहुत गर्मी हो गई है, पानी पी लीजिए। अभी सुनिए, अभी आई हैव टू से टू थिंग्स।
बहुत हवा चल रहा है,
ठंडी हवा चल रही है। वी आर नॉट स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ मिस्टर वार्ष्णे। आई नहीं, ठीक है, अच्छा ठीक है, लेकिन लगता नहीं आप जिस तरह से चिल्ला रहे हैं। लकी आई एंड संबित पात्रा आर नॉट स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ प्रोफेसर वार्ष्णे। टू, आई थिंक वी आर टोटली मिसिंग द गुजरात राइट्स, बिकॉज बारिंग दैट दे हैव अक्यूज्ड ऑफ एवरीथिंग, जीएसटी, डिमोनिटाइजेशन इन अ केस इन्वॉल्विंग लव जिहाद। Now, as far as the Lau Jihad matter is concerned, it was happening right through last 15-20 years. That is why the Supreme Court uses the word pattern.
Jihad,
and the
Lau
word
Jihad
pattern
was,
comes from not
Jihad
one or two instances in
RSS.
Last 2 weeks or three
sir,
weeks.
It, sir, sir, Lau Jihad Lau was Jihad. Generated by RSS only.
RSS se aa sakte hai. RSS se hi aayegi phir aap se aayegi kya? RSS, sir, RSS se hi aayegi aap se.
The discovery of
आप जैसे लोगों से आएगी नहीं ना, आप जैसे लोगों से नहीं आएगी, अच्छे राष्ट्रपति से आएगी ऐसे शब्द।
कांग्रेस वाज कंट्रोली, कांग्रेस वाज कंट्रोली,
यस बिकॉज़ यस आई एग्री, एवरीथिंग यू आर राइट, आरएसएस डिस्कवर्ड लव जिहाद, यू प्रैक्टिस लव जिहाद,
रिक्रूटिंग हु आर बीइंग रिक्रूटेड फ्रॉम
नाविका, आस्क दिस मैन टू कीप शट
आउट बाय द
नाविका, आस्क दिस मैन टू कीप
शट आउट, आई विल नॉट स्पीक, सर अलाउ एमआर वेंकटेश टू मेक अ पॉइंट,
नाविका इफ दिस गाय गोस ऑन लाइक दिस आई विल नॉट स्पीक। No, I will not speak.
Nene, go on. Make your point.
RSS discovered Lau Jihad, but yes, RSS, I agree, RSS discovered Lau Jihad, but Lau Jihad was practiced by these people only. And these people, Mr. Alimuddin Khan's party and Mr. Vashne's party, were tacitly supporting it silently. They wanted this
no,
to happen
no,
or didn't
no,
have
no
the ball to
it.
Stop it.
Or it
that is
it,
the point.
No,
and that is manifesting
it is the
today
mistake
in
of the RSS and the radicalizing of the Islam.
Sir, we know about when in, you know
don't
the point is
responsible any party for it. Congress is not involved such thing.
Please,
I just Congress is a secular party.
I'm running out of time, gentlemen. I'm running out of time.
What did you do?
Dr. Sambit Patra.
What did you do?
As far as Lau Jihad is concerned, the first word Lau Jihad appeared for the first time in the campaign by the Kerala Catholic Bishops in 2009.
Lau Jihad
the Kerala Catholic Bishops.
Lau Jihad me aapne kya kar diya?
500 Christian girls have been targeted. Number two, T.P. Senkumar, who was the Director General of Police of Kerala, was the man who retired, and then he spoke about the whole nexus of Lau Jihad. Tara Sahdev, a great athlete of this country, was a victim of Lau Jihad. She came out and spoke about Lau Jihad. So we all are aware of the fact that there is something called as Lau Jihad.
Dr. Patra,
Supreme
you
Court
say
wants
yourself,
to
you
know about
it. Absolutely. And the NIA. And the NIA. The question we are asking yourself tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and we are getting a lot of your questions on involved.in/newsr. The question people of this country are asking, if there is a video and if Times Now can investigate and link Shafin Jahan, the man who converted Akhila Asokan into Hadia, married her, a man who the NIA says has criminal antecedents, a man who is now challenging the entire annulment of his marriage to Hadia. Should such a man, when he is seen in a CCTV footage causing damage to a hospital property and who's somebody who's identified by the hospital authorities, what's taking the Kerala police and the Kerala government so long to identify him? Is the Kerala government complicit in trying to protect the Lau Jihad factories in Kerala? That's the big question. Even as I thank all my panelists, stay tuned. The news are at 10 coming up next. Don't go away.
The News Hour at 9. We'll be right back after the break.